Hello, I'm being frank with you. It's Saturday morning, sometime in the middle of August. Today we are going through to Edinburgh to the book festival, the Fringe Festival, I don't know which it is. I think my wife has booked us in to see a couple of authors do readings from their books. We're going to drive through to Stirling, a bit like me going to work, and then we'll take the train, so that'll be a bit different. It makes it a lot easier because you don't have to try and park in Edinburgh. It's really, really difficult to try and park in Edinburgh. You usually end up parking a long way away from where you want to be. So with the train, it takes us right into the middle, and then it's just a short walk to where the book festival is held. I can't remember the name of the street. It's a square. Yeah. You'll see anyway later on today. Just while I remember this morning's aggravation with Hastings Insurance, the people who insured my old diesel car, I cancelled the policy in the middle of July, and I got my credit card statement in this morning, and there's the charge for this year's and next year's insurance. So it only took a couple of minutes, but they said, oh yes, they see that I have cancelled the insurance, and then they make the mistake of saying, I don't know why they have charged you. They? Is that not the same company as the person I'm speaking to? Never mind. They say they will give me back my money in 5 days. So I look forward to that. While I'm out here waiting for the family, I'll show you the roof. You can see it is progressing. It's progressing slowly, but it is progressing. And of course, there are always problems. Every solution comes with its own problems. There's a nice phrase, let me think. Every cloud has a silver lining, or most people think in terms of every silver lining has a cloud. And the particular cloud we have is up here. Where is it? Here, here, here. There's a small pipe comes out of the roof. And the roofer is concerned about this. He's concerned that this particular pipe is an overflow pipe. And I keep saying to him, I don't think so, because it's not attached to anything and it's a much bigger pipe than anything else we have in the house. Anyway, my solution was easy. Just cut off the pipe inside the roof space, take it along the roof and put it out through one of the fascias further along where there is already an overflow pipe that we know is attached to something. Oh, good no, he wants to make a big fuss about it, so we'll eventually get a solution, but everything just seems to take so long and have so many discussions. I don't understand why he can't just do the job. And here is the latest delivery of roof tiles. I think there's probably about a ton in each of these. So we've already had 3 lots, so the roof has got to support 6 tons of tiles. That's a lot of tiles, and it's a lot of weight. So we made it to the station. I have no idea which platform we're going. I just follow the crowd. This is inside the Edinburgh Book Festival. There's a lot of people here. Must be a lot of people who read books. I have no idea what this talk is about. My wife has picked this. I'm sure it's going to be really, really interesting. It's a bit like a German Christmas market. Just not too many stalls. Oh, and there we have the castle in the background. Thank you.
to their station, so we're having to wait quite a long time for the next one. So we're sitting in the old station waiting area, and it's nice here because it's still the way it was originally. If you look at the ceiling or the roof, there's a big dome. It doesn't come out where it looks like 2D, two-dimensional, but it's not. It's a big dome. And there's a nice frieze with cherubs around the edges. And then there's other detail in the glass. It's probably been here since the 19th century. But of course it has all the electric mod cons, so that you can find out just how long you have to wait for your train.
I was not able to finish yesterday's log yesterday because my phone ran out of charge. It was on the train coming home, and my son was using the Wi-Fi in my phone, and after a while he said, "Dad, your phone's not working anymore." And my phone was in my pocket. I said, "How do you know?" He said, "Because my Wi-Fi has gone dead." So I've left it all today. Yesterday's talk about universal basic income, UBI, was very interesting. It was an economist from the Netherlands, and he's written a book called about many things to do with universal basic income. But the talk that he gave, it was really interesting. I don't quite know how this works. I know in this country they had been speaking some 2 years ago, and Jeremy Corbyn said that he could argue a case for universal basic income. And the figure he had thought about was £400 for every person per month. Yesterday's talk, they were talking about £1,000 or £800 per month. And the question was, well, how do you afford this without actually just taking away other benefits? One suggestion was that you cancel all benefits, no more welfare state, no more NHS, just give people so many £100 per month and say you have to pay for everything yourselves. I don't think that would work. People are too used to being cared for, and they will not save the money. For example, if we give them £400 per month, they'll spend the £400 per month and still turn up at the hospital emergency and say, "I need treatment, I need you to help me, and I don't have any money." So I don't think that's an answer. I don't really know what the answer is. I must say, I was tempted to put my hand up and ask a question, but not a question for the speaker, more a question for the audience. I wanted to know how many people were dissatisfied with life as they knew it, and if they are dissatisfied, what have they been doing about it 5, 10, 20, and in some cases, as most of the audience were older than me, 30 and 40 years before. We have a system in this country where you elect a government, and we constantly elect people into office, and they don't do all the things that they have said they will do in their manifesto. So I really think in most countries, and particularly in this one, particularly where we have a situation where the country is frequently referred to as UK PLC, we really need to run this country like a business. And that means that you need to have the right people elected into offices. Not politicians, you need to have business people running a country. And I think that's where we're going wrong. Anyway, that's it for today. Or for yesterday, really. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.